I'm Haley Miller. I'm an ecology, evolution, and organismal biology major, and here's what it's like to be in this program. And now we're heading into conservation biology with Dr. Lofman.
We're talking about genetic issues in conservation biology, and super important that we remember that.
EEOB is Ecology, Evolution, and Organismal Biology. It's a very well-rounded major, so you get aspects of all different types of sciences, like physics and genetics, all the way to conservation biology and ecology. And it really sets you up to do research, is what the main goal of this major is for. The classes are pretty hard. It's a rigorous schedule, but the professors are there to support you and help you through it. They're really good resources, and you can get really close with them so that they can help you through the tough classes. And now we're heading into genetics lab.
The first one is going to be continuing on with the PTC lab and doing an agarose gel electrophoresis.
What I want to do with my degree is research. I really like all aspects of it, and I want to go to grad school and probably get my doctorate eventually. So this major is like going to set me up perfectly for that. You can get jobs in consulting, in government work, or like private organizations. There's quite a bit of research areas that you can go into with this major. I chose this major because it had pretty much all aspects of biology that I wanted to study. So I came in already wanting to do a lot of research, and I've been given that opportunity. I've done two of my own research projects, and I've helped on so many other like graduate projects that I have way more experience than I ever could have gotten at like a larger school. And now we're heading into my environmental policy class with Mr. Dan.
We did our introduction to environmental policy, basically spent some time looking at political theory, what is policy.
I decided to double major in EEOB and ESE, which is Environmental Stewardship and Education, because there's a lot of overlap between the two majors. So I already wanted to take some of the ESE classes, so I decided to just do both. The biggest difference is that EEOB, you'll have a more full schedule with it, whereas ESE, you don't have to take physics, you don't have to take genetics. It's easier in the sense of class load. And today we're going to be doing some field work. I'm working on an independent research project, and this is not required of EEOB majors, but it's beneficial because it gets you experience that you'll want for grad school, and you'll be able to do it in a controlled setting. So I'm working with the West Liberty Crayfish Conservation Lab, and I'm doing some work with stable isotope analysis on the crayfish population that lives in that stream.
Learn what it's like to be in this major, and for more information, you can check us out online.